Regiment Army Air Corps Wattisham. They will be back shortly, as Ben explained there, to talk about the amazing capability which they are able to bring. Indeed, we've got another fast jet demo to come, and another very, very powerful one, which hopefully will be able to get a nice patch of blue sky in which to perform its full show, because it really is a very impressive affair indeed.
First sight of some suspect enemy movement ahead to the Special Forces Patrol called Gunship In, who's up the low level bar.
Didn't see that, did we? We missed that one.
What's just happened? Hunter were engaged by rocket-propelled grenades and gunship flew evasive manoeuvres. Gunship 2 on the left has identified the enemy and has drawn Gunship 1's sight onto the target using his laser. Gunship 1 will now deliver quick battle orders to the patrol. If you look beneath the aircraft, you can see the 30mm cannon pointing in towards you.
Is it shooting us?
Look at Gunship 1, closest to the crowd on the left, as he climbs to position for a diving fire rocket attack. Gunship 2 will follow up with a low-level running fire rocket. All the way through the pitch limit from 90 degrees nose up to 90 degrees nose down.
Yeah, I was over there, wasn't I?
Gunship have just destroyed the enemy that were holding out in a bunker using a laser-guided Hellfire missile. Now they climb above the battlefield to assess the engagement. Afghanistan, four British Apaches were deployed to the Mediterranean Sea or HMS Ocean in 2011. They attacked numerous targets in Libya as part of the UN operation there, proving the Apache is a battle-winning asset that can strike both land and sea. From the high hover, prepare to confirm the missiles were direct hit. To return to the target, the pair will fly a pedal turn. This manoeuvre pitches the aircraft to 90 degrees nose up. When the Apache reaches zero airspeed, the powerful tail rotor will turn the aircraft 180 degrees about the centre of the main rotor blade. Now and watch Gunship 1 tip in for the engagement with the 30. Gunship 1 on the right just destroyed the remaining enemy is built in the UK by AgustaWestland. Operations in Afghanistan and Libya have proven that the aircraft is a battle-winning asset that can strike from both land and sea. It provides the UK with an expeditionary strike capability ready to deploy at short notice to defend Britain's interests. Captain Jim Trahern flying Gunship 1 in the lead and myself joined the Army Air Corps direct from Sandhurst. Started flying training as second lieutenant. The Army Air Corps offers a wide range of opportunities for officers, including extended flying roles, maximising the time in the cockpit. Gunship 2, following, is being flown today by Warrant Officers Boats and Nat, along with Sergeant Larkin, Gunship 1, and non-commissioned officers. The Army is the only British service that offers flying wings with non-commissioned rank. Soldiers in the rank of Lance Corporal can be selected to start flying training and promoted to Sergeant on the award of Army Flying Wing. You've now seen the Apaches use their full range of weaponry to help the Special Forces Patrol Hunter beat the enemy. During the next phase of the display, I'll talk a bit more about the Apaches' weaponry and capabilities as they fly low and close up in front of you. If you look above the main rotor blades, you'll see the drone of the Apaches' fire control radar. This can detect 1,024 targets, prioritise 128 fire strokes to the crew, and acquire solutions of up to 16 radar guided fire against Hellfire missiles. The aircraft can sit behind a tree line with just the radar dome exposed above and pass targets to other Apaches in the patrol with data radio message. The other aircraft can then destroy these targets and conceal battle positions without revealing their own position to the enemy. Gunship 2 now pulls up and turns away from the formation and will fly across in front of you, positioned to our left for the next phase. Meanwhile, gunship 1 is ready to fire a heavy switch on you. As the aircraft is going off their orbit performance, it's cautious to the weapon. Sighting unit. This allows the co-pilot gunner to find targets by day and night, discover 127 times magnification. Above the sight, the pilot's night vision system will display the thermal image for the pilot's monocle, allowing flight in absolute dark. Also housed within the sighting unit is an actuator. Ladies and gentlemen, we're almost at the end of today's attack helicopter display. But for more information, you can follow us on Twitter at Apache Display and on Facebook on the Attack Helicopter Display Team page. If you'd like to see the Apache close up, learn more about the aircraft. Also visit the Army Air Corps recruiting stand. Make sure you keep your cameras ready, we still have one last explosion for you. Ladies and gentlemen, as they approach back to the hover, you have Captain Jim Traher and Sergeant Luck in Gunship 1 to your right, and Warrant Officers Pope and Nash in Gunship 2 to your left. Please put your hands together for the 2015 Attack Helicopter Display Team.
Behind in the static park and learn more about flying careers in the Army Air Corps.